Thank you so much, Mr. DSO. What brings me here is to find out how you're doing your monitoring and evaluation during your surveillance activities. My name is Barasa Alex Wanyama. I'm coming from Bomi.
Okay, thank you in the first place. And, I must say welcome to Commonwealth Health District. And my name is Clicker MD Tupayan. I work as the District Surveillance Officer.
So, I would like to know more about your surveillance activities in particular, because you know most of the programs and projects that we carry out, one most important aspect is monitoring your activities and processes and also evaluating them to see actually how you are faring on, to be able to correct whatever is not going well and to strengthen what is going on well. So how do you do your monitoring and evaluation during your surveillance activities?
Thank you. Firstly, yes, when it comes to monitoring, we do activities, we go to federal facilities, we also monitor. That's why even in the supervision tools, you will have surveillance graph as part of the monitoring component. That is one issue. Now, for us, especially for most of Rado County, we have another layer that we refer to as the junior surveillance officer. So as district surveillance officer, I'm charged with the responsibility to supervise all of those junior surveillance officers. For me, I do what we call their timeliness and completeness of reporting, which we do. Those are all strategies we are using to monitor and supervise.
Thank you very much, sir, on that aspect. As the district surveillance officer, you sit here in the district office and you begin getting the results that are coming in, whether they are timely, whether they are late, and you're looking at those particular parameters. However, the process in which they come up with the reports, how do you monitor that process? Which kind of indicators do you have to show that, yes, actually they did the work? And which kind of other indicators do you have to show that actually they conducted the zonal surveillance meetings? Do you have any indicators that you are using? And on the other aspect, you probably have maybe stakeholders meetings that you carry out to improve surveillance of the activities that you come up with out of those meetings. How many of the activities are carried out, are conducted as planned?
Thank you. In the first place, most of our meetings that are held in the district, if there is a Zoom that's supposed to host a meeting, is the responsibility either the DSO or the DSO be present. We have most of our meetings in the...
How do you find any gaps? Do you find any challenges and gaps in your monitoring and evaluation of your surveillance activities? And how best do you think probably anyone can come in to help?
Yes, there are gaps. To have our feedback is a challenge. When there is no support, it is a serious challenge for us. So most of the time, you see our prime partners over and over to please help us. Our partners have been well when it comes to logistics. Because for us in Muscle Rattle, we've been fully supported by our partners. And these are some of our presentations that we made. Like, we will have all the geographical profile of our district. You have the...
Okay. Can I also have a chance to see maybe your filing cabinets where you keep your records?
Yeah. If you look here, you see the ball fast.
So, Mr. Clique, thank you so much for conducting this interview and giving us very vital information.
So, Mr. Clique, can you tell me something
are now very close and approaching to the last corridor so that we can get to the district health office.